So, now that you have some basic familiarity with Angular, let's look at the building blocks of Angular apps. At the heart of every Angular app, we have one or more components. In fact, in a real-world app, we have tens or hundreds of components. But what is a component? A component encapsulates the data, the HTML markup, and the logic for a view, which is the area of the screen that the user sees. Let's look at a real-world example. Imagine we're going to build a website like Udemy. So on this page, we have a navigation bar, a sidebar, and an area to display the list of courses. Now, we can think of all this as one view or one component, or we can break this view into smaller, more maintainable, and potentially reusable components like navbar component, sidebar component, and courses component. Similarly, in courses component, we want to display one or more courses. Potentially, we can break up this component into smaller components. And also, to take this to the next level, each course component can include a rating component. Now we can reuse this rating component in multiple places in the same app or in an entirely different app. As you see, Angular embraces component-based architecture, which allows us to work on smaller and more maintainable pieces that can also be reused in different places. So once again, a component encapsulates the data, the HTML markup, and the logic for a view, which is an area of the screen that the user sees. Every application has at least one component, which we call app component or root component. A real-world Angular app is essentially a tree of components starting from the app component or the root component. Now, in Angular, we also have another concept called modules. A module is a container for a group of related components. Every Angular app has at least one module, which we call app module. As your application grows, you may want to break that module into smaller, more maintainable modules. So in our Udemy example, we can potentially have modules like course module, which includes all the components for displaying courses. We can potentially have another module like messaging module, which includes a bunch of components for the area of the website where you can send private messages to your instructors. We can have an instructor module, which includes the components for instructor's dashboard that you don't see, and potentially admin module, which is the area of the Udemy website managed by the Udemy staff. As an analogy, think of a supermarket. In a supermarket, we have different aisles for different products. We have a section for fruits and vegetables. We have another section for snacks, another for hardware, and so on. The bigger the supermarket, the more aisles we have. In a tiny grocery store, we have probably one or two aisles at the most. The same applies to our Angular apps. So if you're building a simple application, we have only one module, which we call the app module. But as our application grows in functionality, we may need to break that module into smaller modules, with each module responsible for a specific area of our application. In that module, we have a bunch of related components, okay? So this is the big picture. As we go through this course, you will learn about these building blocks in more detail.